Even after going blind. My Omar had such a good life because I gave him such a good life. I was still happy years after going blind. He also could still go through the house, you know. Walk freely through the house. And even when I couldn't any longer have him walk freely through the house, because by the time that he got disoriented and tried to leap into our flat screen TV, thinking he was leaping on the couch, even though we never moved anything. You have a blind pet, you don't, you know, particularly a blind dog, you don't move anything around. We had it exactly the same, but he got disoriented. But even then, he could still go through the house as long as I was watching him, and he slept with me every night. He slept with me every night the 5 months we were at Joe's. And of course, injuring myself, getting tendonitis, possibly from carrying my Omar up and down the stairs at Joe's. There's a lot of times a day to be doing it. Couldn't do it, what do we do? What do we do? I didn't know what I was gonna do. thinking it's a dream. Now it's the middle of the night, but wait, we'll just say I fasted yesterday and then today. I wrote on the calendar, our Omar died today. He's now at peace and we're in pain. It's not like I had those scares with him, including the very first one when he, had the seizure out on the deck. I thought he was gonna die then. Didn't die. And then months later, that whole thing where I took him to beds and I had him on the, he had gotten too skinny and I had him on the and then he had that infection going on in his ear flap, and I had him, he went on that convenia, and then he was like a ragdoll. That's what I thought was going to happen with this. I didn't think he was dead. Scares with him, and he kept pulling through, and he was okay. Why didn't he die yesterday? I don't know. I had these hopes that I could stop him with the CBD, from being so anxious, being not being able to stay at home. I'd had it before, 1,000 milligrams, knock him out, that way he's not so agitated and obsessing over not being able to stand, which is never gonna, nothing I could do for him short of taking him in my arms, and sometimes that didn't work either. That was his dementia. He didn't really want to be cuddled. But lately he was able to be comforted and fall asleep in my arms, and thing happened that it had nothing to do with that soft thing. It was just chance. Maybe it just could have happened anytime. I don't know. Feel like it had something to do with that, because it happened then, handle people dying or no more. That they're, you know. Grandfather was auntie's father, so it wasn't really my blood grandfather. My grandfather, I think he died when I was, did he die when I was in high school? When I was within Joe, with Joe, so I was in my 20s. And I was sad that it goes, I guess, by how close you are, you know? Dad and my aunt died a decade ago, but I had been estranged from her for a while, you know. I was living in California all those years, whatever. I was reading those comments and crying my eyes out. If you type in, why did my dog die suddenly? Because people have this happen where there was no warning sign, there was no anything. Some of them have warning. And some of them, like with me, like the dog was doing okay. There was no leading up to it. There was no, he's sick and then he dies. It's just sudden, like, there were ones who said, you know, it's just, they have younger dogs too. Like I was playing with them, he was eating five, and then he died dead. Like, what happened? And then one guy wrote how I feel. He's like, yeah, I know you guys lose family members and stuff, but to me, my dog wasn't just a dog, he was my son. Most dog owners don't understand that. I don't know what the percentage, but most, huge percentage of dog owners have kids. They have their dogs as extra, but they have kids, you know. I never had kids, but I never wanted kids. There are women who've never had kids who wanted them and couldn't have them, or circumstances didn't work out, or whatever, but I didn't want them. My kid, and my mom's grandkid, or granddaughter. Mom, I'm gonna be okay. I hope so. But I hope so, just in general. I mean, I recently watched her starve herself in front of me for a month. 3 years ago, I thought she could have been dead. She had the seizure and broke her neck and back, fell backwards on our kitchen floor. She was diagnosed with heart problems, cardiomyopathy, whatever, and that she denies. She has brain stuff going on that she denies. So. definitely be identified with Omar dying. I say those words and I can't believe it. I can't believe he's gone. I didn't eat normal. I fasted the day before and then didn't eat normal. And then all the next day, yesterday when Omar died, I didn't eat normal, so. I'm traumatized and I have a horrible headache. Get headaches, and I don't even feel like I can sleep. I was creating a video on this camera and it started going, it's done that before. Maybe it's gonna die on me. He would cry and cry and cry. And I knew that he didn't have to go to the bathroom because I had just taken him out to go to the bathroom. And I knew he wasn't crying because he was eating because it wasn't time for him to eat and he'd eaten. I mean, just in general. And you'd watch him and your heart would break. Sometimes I would just, you know, I'd stand him up and help him walk around the pen just to show him. But then he'd plop right back down because he can't walk around the pen. He can't walk on his own without falling down. But he, and also it's a little tiny space and he doesn't need to. He doesn't need to. All he needed to do was relax. And I had just fantasies that I could give him CBD, high potency, $100 bottle. More than $100 bottle. I just got it on a little bit of a discount. He would be with me. Other dogs live to be 18, 19, 20. Why couldn't my Omar go full circle? Because he was no longer able to stand up on his own and he couldn't stand it. Couldn't stand it. Couldn't accept it. There are dogs that do accept it, I'm sure. Omar wasn't one of them. He could not accept it. He cried. That's why it was heart-wrenching, and that's why I was consistently, you know, I talked to people about it, saying, am I being selfish by not having him euthanized? I can't have him euthanized. I can't do it. I used to say I wish he would die in his sleep so I wouldn't have to have him euthanized. I have to go through that gut-wrenching decision of whether or not to do it, whether I'm being selfish to not do it, etc., etc. But this wasn't dying in his sleep. was at least, it was dying quickly. I didn't know he was dead. I picked him up. I thought something, like, I'll put water on his head or whatever, and then I brought him home. I'm like, Mom, I think he's dead. And then he lost control of his bowels on our couch, and I saw his tongue hang. I knew he was dead. I think when I was, I don't know if he was dead already when I picked him up, but he was dead in a minute. I think he might have been dead when I picked him up, and I just didn't realize. Because again, so suddenly, him crying like he usually does. And my mom's standing there because I had called her in because I was going to go to the mailbox. I'm like, Mom, he's sitting there, he's crying, but just keep an eye on him, make sure he doesn't tip over and doesn't, you know, go under the blanket or something where he can't breathe. I have to put it around that pen when I have the soft bed in there. I do it with the when I have a blanket under there too, or the rug. And you could say if I hadn't put that soft pen in there, would he still be alive now? There's no saying, that's the thing. Was it the soft pen that killed him? Because he sinks in too much? And maybe, I don't know. I know if it killed him yesterday, it didn't kill him other days, so. What's the deal? Why did it happen? I'm never going to have answers. I'm never going to know. I'm never going to know why my dog died. I'm going to second guess myself. I'm going to wonder if it was that. Again, it still goes back to the same thing, that he was so old that I had to constantly worry about him. Constantly worry about him. I no sooner got one nipple of his healed that happened with the other nipple. And then we also see the scrapes and stuff on the legs, that the leg, paw, that I was all up and down the paw that I was putting stuff on. Maybe he had an infection that I just wasn't aware of. I don't know how to tell if something doesn't have pus and doesn't have, you know, with us, if you have pus or if you have a red line going up, you know that that's some infection. But maybe with a dog, it's different. Maybe, I don't know. I kept preparing myself for it, but I still would be like, I don't want it to happen now, please, please, I just want to postpone it. Fate had other ideas. He could have died, broken his neck or something, the night I accidentally dropped him on the kitchen floor several months ago. That would have been an accident, obviously. He wound up being okay. He landed on his, he was fine, but he might not have been fine. I had to constantly worry about him and just because he's so old. I didn't have to do that when he wasn't so old, did I? No. Wondering if Joe's gonna invite me to come down. He'd have to pay for me to do it. I don't think he will. I don't know if I want to fly anyway. Would I if Joe offered to pay for everything? I don't think Joe's gonna do that. I'm just putting it out there in case he does do that. Do it though. So I could say, see, I was thinking that he might, but I don't know. He got all that money, but, you know, something he thought he'd never see. Like being a victim of identity theft and losing out on over $10,000, thinking he'd never see it again. And he got it, but he's putting it all into his house. He's really doing everything with this house. I think he would pay to have him come down, but you never know. I certainly wouldn't say it. I wouldn't hint at it. I would do nothing. Nothing to, at the sort. Not on your life. Any money, so if Joe wanted me to come down, he'd have to pay for my flight, round trip ticket. Even then, I'd be worried sick about my mom. I wouldn't go for very long, maybe like a week. Fact is, I don't have the money, and I'm not even thinking for a second, Joe's. Did when I go? Not right now, anyway. Right now I am grieving. Joe's never experienced this with a pet, so we don't know. Experienced it with people they love, family members, close, whatever, then they don't understand that you're so